Hello, everyone, and welcome to Sunup. I'm Lyndall Stout. Most of Oklahoma's wheat crop is already sown, but some grain-only producers are still in the field. We caught up with our Extension small grain specialist, David Marburger, for some late planting perspective.
Yep, so we're trying to get finished up. We're not too far behind normal, just a little bit, but for a lot of the grain-only wheat that needed to go in the ground in October, we were delayed by some of those rains that we had. So waiting on trying to, for the ground to dry out and then being able to plant and maybe getting another shot of rain and maybe forcing us to have to replant again. So let's just delay things a little bit. And getting into November here, it has dried out since kind of more mid-October here. We could actually use a shot of rain, but it has given us an opportunity to get the wheat planted. One of the biggest management adjustments we need to make when it comes to this late planted wheat is increasing our seeding rate. In mid-October, we can get maybe 2 to 3 tillers produced before we go into winter dormancy. As we delay planting, that window of opportunity for tiller development closes by the day. So in mid-November here, we may get 1 tiller to develop, potentially 2 if it happens to stay warm. So we can adjust for that, compensate for that by increasing the number of seeds that we put out there. And by mid-November and later here, we might have to up our seeding rate by almost 100%. So instead of, for example, 60 pound seeding rate, we might be having to put out 120 pounds to compensate for that, lest it's tiller development.
There's some other compensation too in some other management areas. Start with nutrient management and some things to think about if you're just now getting started.
Yep, so little plants going into winter need all the help they get when it comes to fertility. One option might be, if someone doesn't typically do this, is putting a little bit of starter fertilizer in furrow, a little bit of DAP. For example, 50 pounds per acre of DAP in furrow with the seed gives that little seedling with the little roots an opportunity to intercept some phosphorus right away.
What about pest control and weed management? Are there any special concerns with these later planted seeds?
Well, like anything with late planted wheat, the plants are small. We might have some weeds that are germinating along with them as well, and those weeds are going to be taking up water and nutrients that you're hoping that the wheat's going to be taking up. So trying to control those weeds early on instead of waiting will help give a leg up to the wheat plant. And any pests that you may have out there, if they're reaching thresholds, making sure we're getting on top of that and getting those controlled early.
Now let's kind of switch gears for those producers who planted earlier in the season and are thinking about putting their livestock on wheat. What kind of advice do you have for them? What's kind of that benchmark? And you have some sample plants to talk about.
It's already hard to think. It's mid-November, and for those who planted into good soil moisture, maybe end of August, early September, and got it well established, now is about the time to be getting ready to think about putting those cattle out. So what do we need to look for when it comes to turning cattle out? We'd like to see good top growth overall. Hopefully about 6 to 8 inches of top growth, something that the cattle can get their tongues wrapped around and be able to have a good amount of forage to be able to eat. But we also need to pay attention to what's going on below the soil surface. And we need those crown roots to establish our secondary root system here, the one that's going to intercept the most water and nutrients, as well as anchor those plants into the ground. And you can kind of compare that to a younger plant here. One, obviously, not a whole lot to eat here when it comes to forage, but we don't have that crown root system that has begun to develop yet. So if something came along and tried to eat this, it could pull this plant out. You actually see where the seed is still here, and the primary root system that develops out of the seed first, and then that secondary root system I mentioned, those crown roots, will actually begin to develop right here. And you can see actually one that's beginning to develop. So it's still got a long ways to go before this one could be grazed. But if we have plants that are more this caliber, we're about ready to turn those cattle out and have them start grazing.
Okay, we'll keep our fingers crossed. David, always good to see you.
Thank you.
We'll see you again soon.